Good morning, everyone, everywhere, and welcome to worship with Homer United Methodist Church. It has become our practice to begin our services by acknowledging the people on whose land we live, work, and worship. In this season of gratitude, it is especially appropriate for us to offer our thanks to the stewards of this land. But even more importantly, as we approach the Thanksgiving holiday, this practice helps combat the myths surrounding the colonization of America that erase the harm done to indigenous people. Here in Homer, we live on the unceded land of the Ninilchik Village tribe, who have stewarded this place since time immemorial and will continue to do so for generations into the future. May our land acknowledgement move us toward awareness, to learn and grow in our knowledge of cultures that have nurtured and continue to nurture the very soil on which we stand. And may our growing awareness call us to action, to confess our sin and enter into new and authentic relationship with all of our native siblings. Last week, we began a new series called Thankful, 21 Days of Gratitude, and I invited you to keep a gratitude log every day. You might have one that looks something like this. By the way, this is available in the newsletter for you to download and print yourself, or you can stop by the church office and pick one up. I invited you to write down three things that you are thankful for each day. We know that gratitude is a practice, a spiritual discipline, and as such, we have to intentionally set aside time to reflect on what we're grateful for each day. As you practice this discipline, you will find yourself seeing more and more things to be grateful for each day. When we focus our eyes on gratitude, we see things to be thankful for all around us. Today, we will continue to give thanks. During this season, we are also practicing an embodied prayer. Remember that you can modify this practice in whatever way works best for you physically. You can do the movement standing up or sitting down. You can simply repeat the words out loud, or you can say these words in your head as we pray. So remember that this prayer is from the 14th century mystic Julian of Norwich. It's based on four words: await, allow, accept, and attend. And since we're practicing gratitude this month, I've added a fifth phrase and gesture for give thanks. Each word has a movement associated with it, and we'll run through them together to refresh your memory, and then we will have a moment to pray using just these words. So remember that we start with await, with our hands cupped open to receive at the level of our waist. We await God's presence, not as we expect or hope or imagine it will be, but just as it is right now. Next, we allow and we raise our arms up like a funnel for God's grace. We allow a sense of God's presence to come and be whatever it is without expectation. Then we accept. We put our hands at our heart. We accept a gift of whatever comes or doesn't come. Accept that we are not in charge. We accept the infinity of God's presence, who is present whether we're aware or not. Then we attend. With our hands outstretched in front of us, we attend to what we are called to the actions that God invites us to do. And lastly, we give thanks, using the ASL sign for thank you, hand at the chin and then down. We give thanks and gratitude for God's presence with us all the time. Let's do those gestures again. First, we await with our hands cupped at our waist, awaiting God's presence, however it may appear. Then we allow a sense of God's presence to know it is welcome here within us. And then we accept, hands at heart. We accept whatever gift comes or does not come. We accept that we are not in charge. We accept that God is present, whether we're aware of God or not. Then we attend. We stretch our arms outward. We attend to what we're called to do, the actions that God puts in our heart to make our faith known in the world. And lastly, we give thanks for God's presence with us always. Let's do this one more time, just using the words and gestures. Await. Allow. Accept. Attend. Give thanks. Amen.
Let us pray. Gracious and compassionate God, all creation delights in the radiant presence of your word. May your Holy Spirit soothe our troubled minds, refresh our hearts, and clear our eyes, so we may give you thanks and praise. Amen. Today's scripture reading is Colossians 3, verses 12 through 17. This is the New Revised Standard Version. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom. And with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God.
Did you know that gratitude is not just a practice that helps us grow in spiritual maturity? Gratitude also has mental health benefits. An article from Harvard Health Publishing from August of this year called "Giving Thanks Can Make You Happier" says that gratitude is a thankful appreciation for what an individual receives, whether tangible or intangible. With gratitude, people acknowledge the goodness in their lives. In the process, people usually recognize that the source of that goodness lies at least partially outside of themselves. As a result, being grateful also helps people connect to something bigger than themselves as individuals, whether to other people, nature, or a higher power. In positive psychology research, gratitude is strongly and consistently associated with greater happiness. Gratitude helps people feel more positive emotions, relish good experiences, improve their health, deal with adversity, and build strong relationships. In multiple experiments outlined in this article, people who intentionally practiced gratitude had an increased sense of well-being. The bottom line is gratitude is good for us. Whether it's our spiritual, mental, or social well-being, gratitude makes our lives better. So today, we're going to hear from you. I asked, what are you grateful for? And this is what you said.
Strong and loving and insisted on teaching us children the right things. My father was Scottish and my mother was Irish mostly, and they gave us a happy, happy home. We didn't have much money, but we didn't need that. We had food, Mom had a garden. And that's the first thing I'm grateful for. And I'm grateful for Jim Holton, who gave me 54 years of happy marriage. We didn't have much money either, but it was wonderful. And I guess the third one that I want to mention today is Cheryl. She's my caregiver. And she not only gives me care, but she gives me love, too. So I thank God for those and for a whole lot of other things, because I've had a long and happy life. In fact, it's almost impossible to separate out three things I'm grateful for, because there are so many things I've been grateful for.
I'm thankful for my pet. I'm thankful that I play violin. I'm thankful that I could speak Japanese and a little bit of Spanish.
My name is Rowan Klein, and I'm thankful for school and Christmas and Halloween.
First, I'm glad that I'm able to live in the same little town where my two children and their families are. Second, having spent a few days without internet here at the terraces, I say that I am grateful for technology, which enables us to stay connected with people from friends from long ago, wherever they may be now. Third, I'm thankful for books, and that has subcategories. Books, libraries, bookstores, friends who lend books, trade books, and the Literary Ladies Book Club.
I'm grateful for my daddy because he always cooks dinner for us. I'm thankful for my friends because I always loved to ride on the bus with Taylor. It was really fun. I'm thankful for my mommy because she always makes me feel better when I crash.
My name is Timothy Klein, and I'm thankful for my loving family, for my fun friends, and for my amazing church community.
Flaps on the plane?
No, we this one airplane.
Do you love airplanes?
Yeah.
Are you grateful for Papa's airplane?
No, on this table.
Yeah. No, we don't draw on that table. Are you grateful for Papa's airplane?
Yeah.
What's Papa's airplane's name?
Blue Betty.
Blue Betty. We are grateful for Blue Betty.
Hi, I'm Kyle Klein, and what I'm thankful for is the roof above my head, delicious food, and clean water.
I'm thankful for God. He helps me do math. And I'm thankful for family because I love to see my dad, my parents, and I love to see when I see them, I say hi. And I'm thankful for friends because I like making lots of friends, and I really like to see them, and I really want to make more.
Well, I have a lot to be thankful for. I'm thinking this Thanksgiving time, I'm down here in Washington, and we're with my son and our Terry's sister and family, and it's great to be with family and enjoy Thanksgiving. I'm also quite grateful and mindful that I'm 74 years old and can still do running and activities and I'm helping my son at his cabin here and do work and things like that. So I'm very grateful for that. I hope everyone has a blessed Thanksgiving there in Homer, and we'll miss everybody, but pleased to be here.
Hello. I just wanted to say the three things I am very thankful for. Firstly, my family. I am very thankful for their love and support. The second one is my job and where it's brought me so far. And the third thing that I'm truly thankful for is the amazing church community, Homer United Methodist Church. Thank you.
Three things to be grateful for. We did this as a joint exercise. Marianne chose first, and she chose sunshine. My turn, I chose gravity. And then we agreed on the third one, which was family. So there you have it, sunshine, gravity, and family. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Bo, and the things I'm thankful for are Abraham Lincoln, Santa Claus, and my friends and family.
Hi, my name is Anna Fonkert. I'm thankful for my pets, Ace and Mikey, which are cat,
and dog. My friends and my family. Happy Thanksgiving.
I am overwhelmed with gratitude for each of you. Thank you. We know that no matter what happens to us, no matter where we are, no matter what we go through, no matter how much or how little we have, God is constant. God is with us. God loves us. And for that, we are thankful. Amen. The prayer of gratitude is responsive. Our response is, God, we are grateful. Let us pray. In gratitude for all the good and holy people who have blessed our lives, we pray. God, we are grateful. In gratitude for all those who have spent their lives and energy taking care of the poor and sick and dying, we pray. God, we are grateful. In gratitude for all of those who have spoken up for justice, we pray. God, we are grateful. In gratitude for all the peacemakers in our world, we pray. God, we are grateful. In gratitude for those who have been made to suffer or have been imprisoned for their work, for what is good and just, we pray. God, we are grateful. In gratitude for all who have given their lives as they have lived out the call to work for peace and justice, we pray. God, we are grateful. For the leaders of our community, for the directors of nonprofits, for teachers and administrators, for healthcare workers, for police officers, for volunteer firefighters, for all of those who keep our community safe and healthy, we pray. God, we are grateful. For all the children of the church, their futures fresh before them, and for all our elders full of years and wisdom, we pray. God, we are grateful. For the leaders of the church, for all those who serve in big ways and small, and for each and every member who gives so generously of their time, talent, gifts, service, and witness, we pray. God, we are grateful. Amen.
Let us pray the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Today is United Methodist Student Sunday. It's one of our handful of special Sundays throughout the year in which we make a specific offering. And this one in particular has had direct results right here in our congregation, with several of our college students receiving United Methodist scholarships to help pay for their schooling. United Methodist Student Sunday scholarships are open to all students going to college for any degrees. It is a way that we help raise up the children of the church and set them on a path of success for their lives. I invite you to visit our website for our online donation portal. There is a special line today for United Methodist Student Sunday, and you can make an offering there. Or if you'd like to send a check to the street address on the screen, you can do that as well and mark it for Student Sunday. Thank you so much for your continued generosity. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the eyes of your heart be open to all the blessings which surround you. And may this awareness produce a harvest of gratitude in your soul. May thankfulness rise up within you, not just during this short season, but day after day. And may your prayers reflect that gratitude. And finally, may the grace, peace, and love of the triune God protect, defend, and empower you to run with perseverance the race that is before you. Amen.